the slight unusual part is that the AMD chip seems to be doing at parity at what Nvidia chips are for this particular case. Now, I do not know what kind of workloads Oracle will put on it, so you really can't do an apples to apples comparison. But the story at this point is Oracle has a massive backlog of orders and it needs to invest money to get them converted into revenue. They need to open more data centers or rent out more data centers. They need to buy more chips, buy more hardware, and combine all that together. And eventually then they're going to get paid for all that stuff. So they're going anywhere they can find chips right now. And you know, it seems that AMD is their next stop.
So there are a couple of threads to pull on there. It feels like AMD is increasingly the number one alternative to Nvidia's chips. We can talk about that in a little bit. But what struck me is that there's no dollar amount disclosed in this deal or partnership or promise. The previous deal that AMD struck with OpenAI just said tens of billions of dollars in new revenue. Yeah. Why are firms keeping it so vague?
Well, because they do not know at how many chips they would need, at what point, at what capacity. This is a, you know, that's not, you know, it's more so signaling that we are not just truly dependent on Nvidia. We have other options as well. It helps them with navigating in terms of pricing from Nvidia also. You know, we know Nvidia chips are getting expensive over the last few years. So there could be one reason. The other thing we don't know is what kind of workloads there are, because we know for the absolute best of the best, you have to use Nvidia chips. That's what we know as of today. Whether all of that changes in 12 to 18 months, we don't know. But there are other workloads that may not require that amount of, you know, firepower or horsepower, you could say. For that, you may use AMD chips or something even more inferior.
And even yet another announcement in your space today, Anurag, Salesforce, a company you've been talking to us about for many, many years. Salesforce and OpenAI today announced an expanded strategic partnership. What's going on there?
Yeah, so for me, this is actually a far bigger news and has more ramifications in the long run. If you see what's been happening in the software landscape over the past 2 years, the threat is that OpenAI will come and it'll take away, you know, basically the businesses of all the application software vendors, you know, whether that's Adobe, Workday, Salesforce, HubSpot, you name it, because OpenAI has shown capabilities that their model can help out in functions such as finance, human resources, sales automations, et cetera. This integration between the world's biggest CRM software vendor, which is Salesforce, and OpenAI shows that both of them will be working together. And, you know, it'll be easier for enterprises to go inside OpenAI, ChatGPT, ask for what they want. That gets connected to the data that resides in Salesforce, makes it very easy for the enterprise customers to do their work as well, rather than just going into, you know, Salesforce. So I think this is a bigger news in the long run. But, you know, we are all talking about Oracle as well.
Yeah. OpenAI announces a new deal with someone every day, Paul. This is kind of what you're getting back to. And this really, both of these announcements are the latest in the string of big tech building more computing infrastructure and meeting this demand, this insatiable demand. I've really lost track of the permutations. Anurag, what worries you about these back and forth announcements and partnerships and, you know, the billions of dollars that may or may not change hands? Do we think that these are just announcements that may not come to fruition if circumstances change, for instance, in the next 6 months?
See, from a Salesforce point of view, and which is what I was, you know, you would say most of us are worried about, of the legacy software names, it's a good thing because OpenAI is a new channel of communication with, you know, the rest of the world. If you can integrate your product with them, it kind of saves you from getting disrupted. The question is, in the long run, and then we'll find out what happens is, will OpenAI have that much level of funding to keep up with all the promises that they have? They have given very high revenue estimates for the next few years, but at the same time, I mean, the rest of the bigger, you know, tech vendors are not, you know, just sleeping at that point, I would say. We'll find out whether OpenAI will be able to gain market share from the likes of, you know, Microsoft, Apple, Google, and Meta, or Amazon, or this is going to be just an expansion of the overall market.